Dear students, the last class we have discussed anomalous behavior of p-block elements. Few groups we have discussed, you know that group 13 and group 14 we have discussed in the earlier session. Now we are going to discuss the 15 to 17th group elements, anomalous behavior of 15th group and then 16 and then 17th group. Okay, right? So 14th group, last class we have discussed 13th and 14th group. Now the 15th group elements, 15th group, the first element, you know that the first member of 15th group is nitrogen. What is that? Nitrogen. Nitrogen, the first element, nitrogen differ from other elements, differ from other elements. So like carbon, nitrogen forms multiple bonds. Nitrogen also forms, nitrogen can have the capability to form multiple bonds. Say for example, multiple bonds, nitrogen, it forms multiple bond. Multiple bond. See, multiple bond. See, multiple bonds. N double bond, N single bond, triple bond N, then N double bond, N double bond O. So nitrogen also can have a capacity to form multiple bonds like carbon. See, N double bond N and then N triple bond N, N double bond O. Okay, right? Then one more thing is, nitrogen is a diatomic gas, N2 gas. So nitrogen is diatomic. Diatomic means it has two atoms. It has two nitrogen atoms combined to form a molecule. It is in the form of gas. Unlike other members of the group. Right? The likewise in the 16th group. In 16th group, oxygen is a diatomic gaseous molecule. O2, gaseous molecule. For the electronegative nature of oxygen, it forms hydrogen bond due to electronegativity. So due to electronegativity, oxygen forms what is that? hydrogen bond. For example, water. It makes hydrogen bond. Isn't it? Right. It is one of the familiar example of hydrogen bond. Intermolecular forces between nitrogen and oxygen. One more thing, oxygen will have a high electronegativity. It makes a bond between least electronegative atom like hydrogen. Right. Next one. 17th group. Next one, 17th group. 17th group. The first member of the group. First member of the group, what is that? Fluorine.
fluorine.
The most electronegative atom. Most electronegative atom or an element, you can say, or an element, right? it shows a negative oxygen state. Negative oxygen state, always it shows negative oxygen state, that is -1. It differs from other elements. It has a special character, different character. The anomalous behavior of fluorine is also there, right? So smaller in size, and then oxygen state is always negative. Always it shows negative, because highly the most electronegative atom, so that it is always negative. Then other elements of the same group, similar group, it may be +1, +3, +5, and +7, in addition to -1. Not only it shows -1, it shows a positive oxygen state, that is +1, +3, +5, and +7. For example, chlorine, Cl +1, and then Cl 7 plus also there. For example, what is that? Cl O4 minus. In this case, we can find out the oxygen state of chlorine in perchlorate ion. This is perchlorate. Name of the species, perchlorate. Per means higher oxygen state. See that X minus, you know very well about oxygen, number of oxygen, that is obviously -2. How many oxygens are there? There are 4 oxygen, then -8, which is equal to, there is some charge on it, okay, that is -1. So X equal to 8 minus 1, X equal to +7. So +7, so that we are mentioning per means higher oxygen state. So in 17th group, the first member is fluorine. Fluorine is different from other element, that means it shows anomalous behavior. The first one, the most electronegative atom, it shows a negative oxygen state always. And then other elements of the similar group, it shows +1, +3, +5, and is +7, in addition to -1, right? Then then one more thing is, fluorine is a strong oxidizing agent because it has a high electronegative character, you know that. So it acts as a strong oxidizing agent as well as the most reactive element. The most reactive element among other halogens. So these are all the things, these are all the similar, that means anomalous behavior of different group elements. So far we have discussed, we had completed anomalous behavior of different groups. Next class we are going to discuss the Innert pair effect, the one of the most important property, Innert pair effect. How the elements of different groups, how can you exhibit the Innert pair effect? The reluctance of, before that you should know Innert pair effect, isn't it? That we have discussed in the next class. So far we have discussed anomalous behavior of different groups of elements, that has been completed. Okay, thank you.